After the attack, the council was shattered. Communication with cells across the globe was cut off. Deckard and Lexington were left on their own. Le Fay had ordered my capture to ensure I was witness to his final triumph before my execution as a treasonous Black Order agent.
How is she supposed to bear witness to it if she's blindfolded?
Other options. Their only hope was to pursue the Black Order back to New York and attempt to stop Le Fay before he could install Pandora's box in his machine.
For our choppers to get any closer to the Black Order Tower. It's all on foot from here on out. I'm dropping teams all around the tower so at least one of us has a chance to reach Le Fay's machine. Good luck.
And by one of us, I mean probably you, Deckard. It's probably going to be you. We're in a video game, Deckard. It's probably going to be you. Okay, so Le Fay was doing so well up until... Hold on.
Six, this is Bravo! We've been hit hard! Multiple wounded!
Copy that. Hold position, switch to emergency channel, and request extraction.
So Le Fay was doing so... Fuck. Le Fay was doing so well up until this point. You know, in that mission in the subway, when he was talking to us on the screen, he wasn't telling us any of his plan. He was avoiding, like, all the generic evil villain tropes. I mean, we barely hear from the guy, and now he's capturing his traitors and making them bear witness to his final whatever. Like, he was doing so well as a villain up until this point. Then he had to go throw it all away. What a shame. So this level is a fucking grind. I'm just gonna go through it as quickly as possible. Which still won't be very fast, because... See, I'm just gonna skip explaining this shit, because there's a lot of shit you gotta go hunting for in this level. A lot of shooting down support beams. Luckily, most of these are still fresh in my mind, since, I had, two or three failed takes before this one. Failed recording takes. One of which because the game crashed, which was interesting. I mean, this game sucks, but it doesn't crash all that often. That one got out of my eye line for a second. I mean, at this point in the LP, I'm pretty much out of things to say as it is, so... Like, I'm half tempted to just talk about other games I've been playing. I did that in the at the end of the Cartel LP.
Copy. Switch to supply channel and call in a drop. Roger that.
Oh, I'm going the wrong way. So, I mean, most of this level is just spent hunting down these things. It's not very compelling to watch and or play. That's my second weapon right now. I still have a rocket launcher on me, okay. Just mix things up a bit. How about I try meleeing some dudes? I've been thinking of... Oh. Well, I just wasted some animus since I was trying to pick up the animus. It was bound to happen eventually. When you map all of your animus functions to the same fucking key. Ton of werewolves in this level, in case you haven't noticed. They're really making no effort to mix it up at this point in the game. At this point, they're like, well, they've suffered this long. They've made through this much of the same old repetitive bullshit, level after level. So they probably have, they've probably built up a tolerance to it at this point. But they're probably not expecting much from us anymore, so why should we try to surprise them? I think I gotta go up here to shoot the last support beam, which is right there. Beautiful. I wonder if I can just jump down there. Save myself some time. Like, just jump from here to there, you know? You know what? Oh, God, I forgot there's no quick saving in this game or anything like that. And I don't much feel like replaying this bit, so we're not going to demo that, unfortunately. Oh. Hold on. Much better. Okay, so fuck it, I'm just gonna talk about games I've been playing. Look at this, like, what am I supposed to say about this at this point? What can I say that I haven't said before, or... I've been playing a lot of XCOM recently. I didn't get a chance to play it in 2012. I'm finally playing it now. That's a good game. Fuck, I don't even have much to say about that. That's the problem with trying to say things about games that everyone's already played. You know what? You know what? Fuck it. I'm not gonna talk about games I've been playing. I'm gonna talk about this LPs. Let's talk fucking Let's Plays. Let's talk Let's Plays. So, some of you may know, I don't know if I've really, like, said this in videos before, but, I don't watch LPs of games I've already played, most of the time. Because I've always felt like, well, this is a game I already know about, and I don't really have much interest in, like, seeing 100% runs. So if we're talking about a game I've already played that I've probably already, like, 100%ed, I don't need to watch someone else doing it, unless they're really funny. Oh, hold on. Let's switch to the actual grenades, why don't we? Man, I'm just having no luck with these things. And I died. Because I should have taken some fucking cover. Oh boy. It's gonna be a long episode. So I don't watch LPs of games I've already played. Or that I have an interest in playing. And I don't know who else is like that. I've always felt like, if this is like a game that I want to play, I'd rather just play it myself. I don't really have much interest in watching someone else play it if I'm gonna enjoy it. That's why I only do LPs of, like, bad games, by the way. Because I figure these are games that people will never play, that you shouldn't play, as in this game. Don't play this fucking game. But, yeah, I like to laugh at LPs. I like to laugh at the games, because they're bad, and I like to laugh with the LPers, because hopefully they're funny. Fucking Christ, these grenades suck. The grenades in this game, just fuck it, whatever. Enough tries, I've wasted enough of them. There. I think there was a PDA there. You know, fuck it, I don't even give a shit, I'm not even gonna pick it up. It's not like we're reading the fucking things anyway. Did I actually- nope, I didn't even have enough animus to power that on. And I missed that jump. I need some animus, like, real quick, like. Can I shoot this open, kill him real quick, and grab his animus? Nope. Probably not, right? You'll do just fine, then. I'm real desperate for it right now. Okay, yeah, these grenades, did you see that one? You could literally see where it bounced off the invisible wall. This may be, like, one of the only games where grenades are less effective than the Molotov cocktails. I mean, the Molotov cocktails are pretty useless, too, but I'm just gonna switch back to them, because I can at least, like, kill things occasionally with those. Whereas his grenades have been literally fucking worthless. Oh, and the triumphant return of these guys. Fire Drakes. See, it's not all werewolves after all, guys. And they're like, they're rolling right past me, too, which is... Okay, so I'm actually having to remember right now how to get past this part. But you know, let's charge here for a minute while I rack my brain. Oh, you're stuck. That's right, these guys come up to you with the flamethrowers. Which is as good an excuse as any to swap out that rocket launcher for a flamethrower. And killing all those people miraculously makes that valve appear out of nearly thin air and can make safe passage.
Alpha team, what's your location? We just hit the 10th floor. Roger, wait for Delta to report in.
Pushing these things is like the equivalent of hacking a keypad. Might as well be a keypad.
Repeat, Bravo team, what's your status?
Oh, they're dead.
Bravo team, respond. Base B advised, I've lost radio contact with Bravo team. Copy, we'll send backup.
Like, do they not realize how expendable their own men are at this point? Like, how many levels has it been? You think they would have realized by now. Bravo team, you're not picking up? Okay, they're all dead. Send in more fucking lambs to the slaughter. Whatever. So we're finally back at ground level. And you can tell shit's about to get intense, because we have the main menu music playing. Oh, finally making an appearance in the game itself. You know, it's been mentioned before, and I think I may have mentioned it even, that the music in this game isn't bad. It just all sounds the same after a while. It's all using like the same instruments. Touches upon the same musical themes, I think I may have said, for lack of knowing the proper musical term. Oh man, we got a lens flare. Beautiful. I think there's a green light, a green highlight on that, yep, fuse box over there. So we're getting shot at and we have werewolves on us, which is not a good combo. And they're not, like, infighting at all, so it's literally the whole world versus me. Me and my flamethrower. Oh, but I think I see a way of evening the odds. Except now they stop showing up, so that's... And I think we got a bid farewell. Oh, is that a Desert Eagle there? Oh man, I thought I saw a Desert Eagle for a second. It's just a shotgun, though. I just need something to shoot that fucking fuse box with. I didn't even mean to switch to the fire axe, I meant to switch to the flamethrower, but... Oh, that's not good. And I hope he's actually, damaged by flamethrower, because I don't have much else going on right now. Great. Thanks for, really skimping out on anything I could have used to kill that guy, game. It's really great how you're still giving us the SMG at this stage in the game, despite enemies being pretty much immune to it at this point. Let's just conserve that, why don't we? That we know exactly what we're up against. Well, I guess the flamethrower doesn't work on this shit. That's awfully nice of the devs. Just make us waste our fucking bullets. Real fucking considerate of them. Just gotta finish off these guys first. Burn them all to a crisp. Come on. Oh, apparently I'm stupid. Apparently that's... Okay. Alright. So back to LPs, because there's nothing to fucking say about this game. Really, there's not a goddamn word to say. I'm completely spent. There's one episode left after this one. I'm just finishing this for the sake of finishing this at this point. So I don't really care for informative LPs. Never have, never will. You'll never see me do one either. Just need my concentration on for a second. Just a second. Okay, we're good. So, no, if you like them, that's fine, I guess. Dork. But it's like the same thing I said before. Like, if I want to play a game, or is a game that is of interest to me, I'd rather just play it myself, thank you very much. If I need, like, a walkthrough on how to play it, if I need to know the location of all the items in the game, I'll read, like, a text document, I'll read an FAQ, I'll go to GameFAQs, and I'll look that shit up myself. Oh, nope, I don't even have the Animus to power that thing. I need Animus to heal, but I also need to get those monsters fighting those guys with guns for me, so... It's an actual honest-to-God dilemma! I actually have to stop and think about that one for a second. Oh, I may have actually gotten them with the first grenade, okay. That's a nice change of pace. That thing should still be charged for another few seconds at least. Not like it matters, no one's attacking us right now. And that brings us back to this guy, huh? Grab that bit of health while we still can. Alright, let's just hope that his range is as bad as ours is. Where's the last one? Hi. You know what? Fuck you. I'm gonna watch you burn. That's how mad I am at this game. I'm actually taking joy in killing the bad guys. That's just how upset I am right now that I'm still having to play this fucking thing. Oh no. By the way, there's no waypoint here. I'm holding on the waypoint key, but nothing's popping up still. So no direction of where to go. No indication. Is that a dude up there? No? Okay. Maybe the game thinks it's obvious where I'm supposed to be going? Oh, I guess it is sort of obvious. Unless you completely overlook it, in which case it's not obvious. And here's our last chance to stock up before one of the most tedious, most frustrating parts. I was going to say in the level, but maybe the whole game. Oh, these things don't actually work, do they? They put them in the game, but they didn't bother. They didn't bother making them actually functional as turnstiles.
Alpha under attack! Werewolves coming in from all directions! Copy! All other teams are currently engaged. Hold out until reinforcements are available.
Yeah, I'm sure it's gonna go real well for them. Nice knowing you guys. Ooh, there's some corpses here. This is probably supposed to be real gut-wrenching too, if I had to guess the developer's intent.
Sixes is Bravo! We've been hit hard! Multiple wounded! Copy that. Hold position, switch to emergency channel, and request extraction.
Why do we have to hear this? What does it matter? Everyone's gonna die. Hey, can I get on the radio? Can Deckard get on the radio for a second? Hey, Bravo team, this is Deckard. Ah, Deckard, you can speak? Yeah, I know, I've just been quiet. I haven't had much to say until now, you know? Anyway, you're gonna die. Like, literally all of you, you're all gonna fucking die. Everyone in this game fucking dies. Every NPC I've ever met. Don't worry about what NPC means, by the way, we're in a video game. You're all gonna die, like, really painful, brutal deaths. And I'm gonna watch most of them. I mean, sure, granted, the ones are gonna happen off-screen, but let's take my word for it. If you and me ever meet, you're gonna fucking die. Like, some monster's gonna grab you, tear you in two. That one seems like one of their favorites. I mean, I'm gonna be fine, though, so, you know, thanks for distracting him so that I can live. I'm just thanking you in advance right now, because you're gonna die. Because you're gonna fucking die. See, you could have had Deckard be voice acted. I could have done it. Spark, hire me. Let me voice act for your next game. I'll play main character in Lost Planet 3. You probably have him as a silent fucking protagonist too, right? So let me do that shit. We still don't have a waypoint, by the way. We still have no mission waypoint. And I don't feel like shooting any of these dudes, but they're gonna make me at this point, aren't they? This is what I meant by the most frustrating part of the level and or game, by the way. This part right here. Okay, I gotta Pied Piper them. Get them in a line behind me. Oh, this is gonna be real close, isn't it? Basically, since we don't have waypoints, what we need to do is we gotta destroy all these pods. And then there's two things that we gotta... Well, never mind that shit. I fucking died. Again. Oh, this must be real fucking fun to watch. This is... I'm getting so fucking mad. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry that I'm like a fucking mad asshole right now. But oh my god, try playing this fucking game. Then try having to play it on a fucking, like, sort of schedule. And, like, being forced to finish it. I'm not being forced. I shouldn't say fucking forced. That sounds really pathetic and stupid. Try making a commitment to, like, finishing this game. And then having to fucking finish it. Okay, let's just sprint through this section. These things are gonna hurt me no matter what, so let's just pretend they don't exist. Probably what I should have been doing the first time. But I was thinking I can maybe avoid taking damage if I tried killing him. Oh, I should probably explain this. You turn these valves to turn on gas lines. Up until this point in the game, they've only turned on water, but for some reason they changed it up now. And then you can burn that bit and cause a fire that stops the enemies from respawning. And that's what we have to do here in order to progress. Okay, if by let's get up there you mean you guys are just gonna stay here and get killed, then okay, be my fucking guests. Wait, did I say earlier that LeFay was doing a good job avoiding being like a stereotypical generic evil villain? I guess having a gigantic tower in the middle of the city, New York City, sort of disqualifies him from that, after all.
Engaging phased startup sequence.
Man, this game sure does love its particle effects. Oh, by the way, you may be asking, how do I know we're in New York City? Hey, it's ahead of the Statue of Liberty. Who'd have guessed? Oh boy, that's sort of obligatory at this point, right? It's not a proper apocalyptic scenario until the Statue of Liberty has been thoroughly thrashed. Oh, and hey, what do you know? It's the end of the level. Oh, time sure flies when you're punching your fucking keyboard. Oh, join me next time for the exciting conclusion. I said exciting conclusion. That's my bad. Join me next time for the tedious conclusion to this tedious game.